Kimraha Huladunia, Falchagu, Ye Olde Scots, the Celtic Podcast. On today's show, in Feuchamaich Beagan Gaelic, we will continue our 25-week beginner's Gaelic course with Lesson 9. We will talk about Micheal Collins in our three-part series, today's part 2, in Celtic History segment, and you'll hear about the Celtic League and the Celtic Congress in everyday Celtic ways. Now, throughout the program, we're going to hear music from Allison Helzer, Kepper Cayley, the Rankin family, and Karen Matheson. And as always, it's a wee bit of trivia to test your knowledge to start us off. So what is the place in County Cork, Ireland, named where Micheal Collins was assassinated? All right. Check out Ye Olde Scot Facebook group, where you can be a part of the Celtic culture, post memes, give me ideas, tips, even criticism. All right, Kershmaha, let's kick this thing off. That was Ambulical Band by Kepper Cayley. And now, hi, I'm Tom and Feuchamaich Beagan Gaelic. It's time for Let's Try a Little Gaelic. Now, I do not represent myself as an authority on the Gaelic language, only someone who loves learning it and wants to help others. What I teach comes right from the textbooks of well-respected Gaelic teachers, so I hope you find it interesting, informative, and fun. Today we will begin with, we're in a 25-part Gaelic lesson. And as always, We're going to be in lesson 9. It's going to be talking about months and days. And as always, I'll display on the screen what I'm discussing. All right. So, first thing we're going to get into are the days of the week. So, just to say days is Leichen, Monday, Jeluin, Tuesday, Jemarsht, Wednesday, Jekiatin, Thursday, Jiadun, Friday, Jehunia, Saturday, Jesaharnia, Sunday, Jiadonach, and Sunday, you can say that, or you can say Lanasavich, which literally means day of the Sabbath. All right. We'll move on to the months. And this one I might butcher up a little bit because I haven't really practiced too much on the months. So I'm going to do the best I can. All right. January, Fulach. February, Gerlin. March, Marscht. April, Giblin. May, Caton. June, August. July, Lucre. August, Lunastal. September, Sultan. October, Davr. November, Samhain. December, Duvlach. All right. I think that went pretty well. To write the date in Gaelic, add the day and the month in the same order as you would in English. Don't worry about writing the 1st or the 2nd or the 21st or the 20th. Just write the number. Now, here are some examples. Monday, 12, January, 2017, okay, is Jeluin 12, Fulach 2017. All right. And Wednesday, 20th, May, 2017, is Jekiatin 20, Caton 2017. All right. I guess you could speak out. You could say Jekiatin, Fikit, Caton, Damila, Shak, Jig. All right. But I'm sure if you said it the other way, nobody would have a problem with it. All right. Translate these into English, these 6 sentences here. And we'll start with number 1. Hamiadol Ananjiluin. Number 2. Avelu en Skol Andaver. 3. Avel A Shia Giblin and Ju. 4. Hamiadol Amok Jehunia. 5. Hashingaki Ahulala Jesaharnia. 6. Haf Holak. Ha Folach Hohur. Oh, man, yeah. That's a hard one. It's got all that lenition in there. My tongue doesn't want to wrap around it. Ha Hulach Hohur. There we go. All right. Don't worry. I'm getting it. Some of these Gaelic sentences, they really are tongue twister for us Americans. All right. Well, that's it for Feuchamaich Beagan Gaelic. Hope you liked it. Hope I didn't butcher it up too bad. I'm working just as hard to learn this as everybody else. So, thank you very much. Top live.
Through a hatami, you're a
Today on Celtic History Break, we're in the Micheal Collins series. We're doing part two today, Politics and the Irish Conflict. Now, in December of 1918, just a month after World War I ended, there was a general election of the British Parliament. Now, since Ireland was part of the United Kingdom, elections were also held there. The result was that Sinn Féin won 73 seats. The Unionist Party, members of Northern Ireland who wanted to remain part of the United Kingdom, won 26 seats, and the Irish Parliamentary Party, which had been the dominant party in Ireland, only won 6. Micheal Collins was elected to the British Parliament on a Sinn Féin ticket. The Sinn Féin members refused to go to London to take their seats, though. Rather, they set up their own parliament in Dublin. Since they were essentially setting up a separate government, the British viewed their actions as treason. The Irish Parliament, called the Dáil, set its first meeting on January 21, 1919, and on that same day a small group of Irish volunteers attacked a police transport at Solihull in County Tipperary, killing 2 policemen. Now, most historians use that incident as the start of the War of Irish Independence, or, as it is more commonly known, the Black and Tan War. Of course, it refers to the black and khaki uniforms worn by the Irish parliamentary paramilitary forces that enforced British rule at that time. Now, during this period, the Irish volunteers renamed themselves, and they renamed themselves the Irish Republican Army. A few months later, in addition to his duties with the IRA, Collins was appointed Minister of Finance for the Dáil, but he was not present for his first meeting. He was in England at the time, working on a plot to spring Eamon de Valera out of Lincoln jail. The plot proved successful, and on February 3, 1919, Collins personally participated in de Valera's escape. Collins was back in Dublin by March 29th when he organized another mass escape of about 20 prisoners from Mountjoy Prison. Although there were regular British troops stationed in Ireland at the time, the British primarily used the Royal Irish Constabulary, the RIC, and Dublin Metropolitan Police, the DMP, to rule the country. Now, the IRC was a paramilitary force that was stationed in barracks, armed with rifles, and had spies and informers in every village and town throughout Ireland. Somewhat surprisingly, the RIC was composed primarily of Irish Catholics. The DMP had 7 divisions. Some operated in Dublin, while others operated outside of the city. And its intelligence unit division G, was composed of plainclothes detectives. And on the night of April 7th, 1919, Collins, with the assistance of one of his spies, sneaked into G division headquarters and spent the night examining top secret files. After viewing them, Collins concluded that the key to defeating Britain was to cripple its intelligence network. He wrote that England could replace every soldier that was killed, but that without her spies, she was helpless. He also realized that spies are less willing to replace spies that have been killed, and that, even if Britain could find replacements, the new spy would not have the previous spy's knowledge. So therefore, Collins began a sustained and systematic attack on both the RIC and G Division. Now, to fight the RIC, Collins used the IRA Flying Columns, a small but highly mobile guerrilla groups of poorly armed men, usually no more than 30. On April 20th of 1919, the IRA staged its first raid on an RIC barracks. They seized rifles and ammunition, which of course made them better armed. Now, during the next few months, the IRA intensified its attacks on the RIC. As a result, some of the smaller RIC barracks were closed, and the troops were transferred to larger barracks in the cities and towns. Now, to fight the G Division, the Intelligence Division, in July of 1919, Collins organized a small group of young volunteers assigned to the IRA's Intelligence Department, known simply as the Squad. Now, their mission was to assassinate detectives and other British spies and to do it with impunity, meaning that only the most loyal and ruthless were chosen to be in the squad. Now, the squad usually gave potential targets a warning, and if they responded by performing their duties less zealously, they were spared. But those who failed to heed the warning were killed, no exceptions. Now, the squad's first victim was Sergeant Patrick Smith, who had ignored several warnings before being killed on July 30th, 1919. Now, the British responded by becoming even more repressive. They banned Sinn Féin in August 1919 and outlawed the Irish Parliament the following month. As a result, the Dáil only met once in the next year. On September 12th, Dublin police sacked Sinn Féin headquarters. Collins, who was president at the time, escaped when the police did not even recognize him. He had avoided having his picture taken and seen in public. He also fomented misinformation about his appearance, in order to confuse the police and the RIC and the DMP. So now, unwillingly, he let the raid on Sinn Féin headquarters go unavenged. Collins ordered the squad to kill one of its leaders, Detective Daniel Hoey. Now, that very same night, as a result of the IRA attacks, many RIC and DMP members took early retirement, while many others became visibly unenthusiastic in performing their duties. In addition, RIC recruitment plummeted. In an effort to restore order, the British sent in reinforcements from England, and the ramp-up of military forces in Dublin and around Ireland started changing the tide of people's opinions of what was going on. The strive for independence started getting a lot more support at home. All right, that's it for Celtic History Break. right, that was Cosha Carruin by Capricale. Now it's time for Everyday Celtic Ways. Today we're going to talk about the Celtic Congress and the Celtic League, which are not super cool organization of Celtic superheroes, I wish. No, around the beginning of the 20th century, important figures throughout the Celtic nations felt their joined and individual entities eroding under the nationalist and globalist threats. So they decided to do something about it. The Celtic Congress first met in 1917. It was convened by E.T. John, and it's true that they were gatherings of Celts at the very beginning of the century. The Celtic Association invited Celts to Dublin in 1901, and after a successful meeting, they did it in Liverpool in 1900. Wales also did something in 1904, and there was grand, ambitious gatherings were held. There was, however, no central organization, though. And that is what E.T. John had in mind. If he thought, if this group was ever to become what he envisioned, it would need dedication to the cause of promoting Celtic language and culture, and, of course, plenty of organization. With his guidance, the Congress grew in stature and importance, drawing speakers and interest from the highest-ranking politicians, religious leaders, and notable people of the times. Now, the Celtic Congress stated purpose is to perpetuate the culture and ideas, the languages of the Celtic peoples, and to maintain an intellectual contact and close cooperation between the respective communities, the Celtic communities of Scotland, Ireland, Wales, Brittany, Galicia, and the Isle of Man, all of which have in common the Celtic language and culture. Now, each Celtic country or area shall have a national committee consisting of representatives of national, cultural societies, and others. The International Committee consists of President, Vice President, International Secretary, and Treasurer, and has like 12 representatives who represent the six national committees, and they serve as the governing body for the whole thing. And they hold an annual International Congress in one of the six Celtic countries. They, you know, change it on a rotation, you know, every year. The purpose of this meeting, though, is to discuss and promote and preserve the Celtic languages and the culture and the prospective nations, to advance learning the Celtic languages and promoting the culture. Now, most of the advances in language and culture can be directly attributed to the influence over the years of the Celtic Congress and its representatives. Now, the Congress strives to keep its agenda non-political, even though it attracts a lot of elected leaders, politicians, and others. There's another group that focuses on the politics, and that is the Celtic League. It is an inter-Celtic organization that campaigns for the political, language, culture, and social rights of the Celtic nations. Now, it does this across the board, across a broad range of issues. It highlights human rights abuse, monitors military activity, focuses on political, social, economic, environmental, language, and cultural issues, which generally or specifically affect one or more of the Celtic countries in some way. The organization also aims to further each of the Celtic nations' right of independence and to promote the benefits of inter-Celtic cooperation. Additionally, the League draws attention to matters that bear a wider concern for the peoples of the Celtic countries. All right, I'm going to post up the websites for these, for the Celtic Congress and the Celtic League, and I really advise you to take a look at them, a closer look. It's really interesting. All right, that's it for Everyday Celtic Ways. Hope you liked it.
And I'm dying, oh, he.
right. That was Aileen Dune by Karen Matheson. And you can see her singing that in the movie Rob Roy with Liam Neeson and Jessica Lange. That's it. Well, that's it for today's show. Hope you liked it. I'm trying to keep it interesting, informative, and fun while showing you the beauty of all things Celtic. Top 11 Kerchin. Thank you, friends, for all the support this year, during this past year. And I really appreciate it. Now, before I let you go, the trivia question answer. The place in County Cork, Ireland, where Micheal Collins was assassinated is called Beagan. All right. Remember to check out my YouTube channel, Ye Olde Scot, with my Learn a Gaelic Song videos, my Celtic podcast videos, all the Speaking Our Language videos, Celtic movies and Gaelic movies, and other videos as well. Check out the Facebook group where you can actually be a part of it, post memes, and do all kinds of things. Be actually a part of it. All right. Martian Leave and Drosda, bye for now. I will let you go with a song, Tell My Ma by the Rankin Family.
Tell my ma when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They pulled my hair and they stole my comb, but that's all right till I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City. She is courting 1, 2, 3, please would you tell me who is she?
Albert Mooney says he loves her, all the boys are fighting for her. Knock on the door and they ring the bell, oh my true love, are you well?
Here she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers and bells on her toes. Old Johnny Murray, he says she'll die if she doesn't get the fellow with the roving eye.
Tell my ma when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They pulled my hair and they stole my comb, but that's alright till I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City. She is courting 1, 2, 3, please won't you tell me who is she?
At the wind and the rain and the hail blow high and the snow come tumbling from the sky, she's as nice as apple pie, she'll get her own boy by and by. When she gets a lad of her own, she won't tell her ma till she comes home. Let the boys stay as they will, for it's Albert Mooney she loves still. Tell my ma when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They pulled my hair and they stole my comb, but that's all right till I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City. She is courting 1, 2, 3,
please won't you tell me who is she?
Tell my ma when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They pulled my hair and they stole my comb, but that's all right till I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City. She is courting 1, 2, 3.